Have you ever sat down to your computer, focused on your most important project for the day, and said to yourself something like, okay, we need to get this done by the end of today. Let's just focus on this for the next hour, and we're going to have a fantastic day. And before you know it, a few minutes later, you find yourself wandering on YouTube, or maybe social media, or some other website that is distracting you or pulling you away from your most important work. Well, in today's video, I want to introduce you to Cold Turkey Blocker, a website and application blocker to help you combat all of those distractions. Hello everyone, Scott Friesen here at Simpletivity, helping you to get more done and enjoy less stress. And Cold Turkey Blocker may just be the most effective and hard blocker to beat so you can focus on that most important task. So let's take a look. Here we are within the Cold Turkey Blocker dashboard. And Cold Turkey is actually an application that you install on your computer, on your device. It's available for both PC and Macs and also mobile devices. And the great thing about that is that you can actually block applications more than just websites. But today, we're going to be looking at probably the number one culprit for most of us, and that is websites. So to get started, what you're going to need to do is either create a new block list, or we can use the default block list in which Cold Turkey comes with. So you have about 54 sites here in this default list called distractions. I'm just going to click edit here so you can see what's going on within this list. So if I scroll through here, you can see here's the 50 plus websites. We've got all of the major social media websites. We've got a lot of video, including Netflix and YouTube, and a lot of entertainment, and I think a lot of funny websites in this list as well. Now, of course, you can add to this list at any time. You can just type in the URL here at the top, or you can make your own as well. Here I've created one called No Video. It's pretty simple. All it has is Netflix or YouTube. If I want to create a new block list, I just add block list at the top left. I'm going to call this one, let's just call this one social, let's spell it right, social media. And then I can just, again, I can just start typing in what social media websites. I'm going to add Facebook. I'm going to add Twitter. I'm going to add LinkedIn. Although it is business related, sometimes we can get lost on LinkedIn as well. And I can always edit this over time. You can also import other lists because I know there's some great websites that have some great lists of their own. But what I like to do, you probably only have a good handful of websites that you know you are tempted to visit more often than you should. So you might want to just start with a list of maybe half a dozen to 10 or 12 that you know are your biggest culprits and add them to a list. I can hit save, and now I've got my block list here. The next thing that we want to do is we want to go over to timers. So here you can see the different lists that we've created. And I'm going to do a quick example here. So I'm going to use the distractions list. I'm going to use that big list there. All you need to do is say, when do you want to block all of these websites until? So I'm going to pick today, and I'm just going to do it for a couple of minutes here. So I'm going to say 10:30. Now you can choose breaks if you like. Here you've got a few different defaults here, sprint A, B, and C, and allowance A and B. I'm going to show you more details about that a little later on. So I'm going to say none for the time being. And last but not least, when we're ready to go, we can hit start, or we can turn this to on. Now you're going to get a warning here. It's going to say, are you sure you want to block distractions for about 6 minutes? This action cannot be reversed if lock timers is enabled. Now you can go into settings and change this default, but I think this is exactly what makes Cold Turkey such an effective blocker, is because you can't skirt around it, right? If you need distraction-free time, you want to make it extremely difficult, if not impossible, for you to go to that website or to go to those social media or video or whatever that website is and take you away from your most important goal. So I'm going to say, yeah, I'm sure. I want to be distraction-free. So now if I go to the internet, and look, I've already got YouTube pulled up here. I'm going to go to that YouTube tab and Vince Carter dunks. Let's go. Oh, no. I've been blocked by cold turkey. And cold turkey will even give me a bit of an inspirational quote. Your time is limited, so don't waste it living someone else's life. Okay, what about Twitter? What if I want to go to Twitter? I want to click on something here and, oh, no, cold turkey again. And I've got my inspirational quote here by Mark Twain. You may think that this is kind of cheesy, adding these different quotes here when you reach a site which has been blocked, but sometimes it can stop and make you think about, oh yeah, this is the most important thing I should be working on. I should really be coming back to this report. This needs to be done today. I need to be head down. Now, you're probably thinking, how can I work my way around this? Well, how about incognito mode? Yeah, let's go into private browsing. There's no way it's going to skirt around private browsing. Let's go to facebook.com and even in private browsing, doesn't matter how slowly you go as long as you do not stop. So this again, I think is one of the great things about cold turkey is that it's gonna block you even in private mode. It's gonna force you to get back or really strongly encourage you to get back to that task that you need to do. So let's go back into the interface. This block is still on. It's still going to remain on for a few more minutes, and I'm going to show you what happens when the block is over. But until then, I want to show you some of the other features here within cold turkey. There is a scheduling feature. So if you want to have distraction-free time at certain points of the day, you can build that right into your schedule. So here I've got a few different blocks here where I want to be distraction-free. Let's say I want to add in another one. Maybe I want to do some head-down writing tomorrow morning. Let's say early tomorrow morning. So I'm going to say 7 a.m. Just click and drag. I'm going to say 7 to about 9 o'clock. About there. When I let go, I can see this little dialogue. I can adjust the time here. And here I can choose which distraction list, right? So do I want the bulk, the 54 site distraction list, or is it really video that hurts me the most in the morning? So why don't I say no video at that time? We're gonna leave breaks alone for now, and I'm gonna hit save. So now automatically, I don't have to start a timer. I don't have to initiate anything. I'm going to have those particular sites blocked during that time tomorrow. And this is such a simple interface. I like the way that they've designed it here, is that this is going to be your weekly schedule. So you can adjust it over time. But for many of us, you may have a certain routine or a certain time of the week where you really need that distraction-free time. You can build that in here as a part of the schedule. Okay, let's get back to breaks. Under settings is where we can edit our breaks. And there's two different types. There's our daily allowance, and then there's our sprints down below. So the daily allowance, it gives you two different options, allowance A or allowance B. Let's say you want to allow yourself, you know, 20 minutes of free time, or allowance B I've got set here currently for 60 minutes. So you're allowed a certain number of time to go to those websites, to, you know, watch videos, to browse and contribute on social media. However, when that time is up, it's going to block those particular websites. Sprints work a little bit differently. And if you think of the Pomodoro technique, you can choose how long you want to work and then how long you want your break to be. So of course, during the work time, you're not going to be able to access those websites and those applications, but you will get a few minutes break if you need to get away and you want to watch a YouTube video such as this one right now. The one other area that I want to show you here in part of the interface is statistics. Cold Turkey does provide some high-level statistics here as to your top five apps that you have been using and the top five websites that you are visiting. Now, this isn't very granular. In fact, it's pretty basic stuff that it's showing you here in terms of those websites and the amount of time that you're spending there, but you might be able to see a bit of a theme over time. All right, so there we have the little announcement here in the bottom right-hand corner. Well done, your time blocked named distractions is now over. So you will get a similar notification on your desktop when that distraction-free time is done. Now you can adjust these notifications if you like, but it can be helpful if you're looking forward to that break and if you, you know, need to get away from that important task or that most important to do and do something a little more frivolous, maybe something a little more entertaining. If you'd like to learn more about cold turkey, you can go to getcoldturkey.com and try all of these features for free. There is a basic version which gives you all of the website blocking functionality. And if you'd like to block even other things such as applications and games on your computer, well, you can upgrade to the pro version and do that as well. Thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope you subscribe right here to the Simpletivity channel. And remember, being productive does not need to be difficult. In fact, it's very simple.